Level 2, Identification of the Wetlands. Unlike the federal and small-scale geodata, local, large-scale or ground-level, geodata normally demand substantial time to be computed due to the high resolution and accuracy involved. Aerial images, high-resolution satellite images and LIDAR are the most data-intensive information in GIS in terms of storage and interpretation requirements. Minimizing computational efforts by analyzing the landscape, subdividing the geography into semi-homogeneous units, selecting units for further detailed analysis, and prioritizing areas of interest is key to reducing the geographic extent of the study, reducing the computational cost of the study, and supporting the top-down approach in geospatial analysis in which the analysis funnels options down into a reduced set of possible alternatives. Given the completion of level I processing described, a series of GIS analyzes using information extracted from the topographic surface, such as topographic depressions and flat areas, as well as image analysis such as land cover, provided enhanced inputs to refine wetlands feature geometry as well as classifications based on the radar-based wetland mapping results. The following processes were developed for the watershed number 0, which is second in the ranking as shown in the results section. It serves as a representative example for more detailed examination in this lecture. The reason is that the top-ranked watershed covers a small area and is mostly composed by developed areas and does not present a large variety of landscape features, including wetlands, to illustrate the exercise proposed in this work. The geospatial analysis was performed using map algebra, so features in vector formats were converted to raster format. Due to landscape analysis considerations and the potential implications of I-269 and planned roads, the layers of information selected in this level, level 2, emphasize the hydrographic and physical aspects, which are basis for engineering construction perspectives. The layers employed to refine and rank the wetlands per watershed. For display purposes, the impact factor ranges from green, low, to red, high. Table 2 presents the layers used to refine the wetlands features, their respective criteria for classification and the weight to be used on MCDM. Distance criteria and weights are hypothetical, however, they reflect the goal of the paper on assessing potential impacted wetlands. Layers, criteria and weights used on Level 2 analysis. The weights are included in the multi-criteria decision tool as input rankings. The tool was developed as part of the SEP in CRSD project and implemented based on SADI's HB method. The normalized weights are used as factors in the map algebra equation that is responsible to produce the cumulative cost surface, where high cost would represent higher environmental impact,